Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 14. Today I'll be showcasing the use of the Golden Triangle Crop Overlay, the Radial Filter Tool, and the Adjustment Brush. So this was a picture that I took actually yesterday when I was in town running errands. It had started to rain, and as I finished my errands, I couldn't resist pulling my camera out and taking a shot of the hood of this car. I was trying to capture the rain rolling off the hood. And this is the best of the shots that I got before the skies really opened up and I needed to put my camera away. So I'm going to begin by cropping the photo. What I want to emphasize here is the logo and these rivulets of rain. So I'm going to click the crop overlay tool and I'm going to pull it in. And again, as I always do, I unlock the aspect ratio because I'm not going to frame this photo. That gives me a little bit more freedom in how I crop. So I'm going to bring it here and bring this up just a bit. And now to see how this works in terms of composition, I'm going to scroll through some of the crop overlays. And in Lightroom, you do that by hitting O on your keyboard. And there's the rule of thirds. And you can see that the Ford logo lies a bit at the intersection of two of the lines. So that crop tool will work, or that crop overlay will work. I want to keep these lights in over here. And I want to keep the Explorer here as well, some of the letters in. So let me see some of the other overlays. This is diagonal. And this is starting to become one of my favorite overlays. This is the Golden Triangle. And the concept here is to have your subject fall within one of the triangles. So here, what I like is that the lights are in this right-hand triangle. What I want is for this large rivulet of rain to be within the same triangle as the logo. So I'm going to push this up a bit. And I think, you know, that makes sense. I like how that looks there. Now, I can change the rotation of this overlay should I want to by hitting the shift key and then pressing O, and you'll see it will change. So it depends on your composition, on your photo, which of these orientations might work for you, but this one works here. So I'm going to hit done, and there you have it. This is where I will begin my edits. Now, in looking back in the history of my originally edited photo, I did a lot of crazy things, and it ended up great. In the end, I could probably have accomplished what I did in different steps, perhaps fewer steps. So bear with me as I work and show you the steps that I did use, and you'll see the craziness that ensues. So first, I'm going to increase the exposure because obviously it's a bit dark. So we're going to pull up the exposure and to reveal what's there. And I'm also going to, based on what I did before, I pulled up the highlights quite a bit. And I also, I moved the white slider a bit just to move the histogram, or begin to move the histogram, get some white tones in there. On the other hand, I also am going to slide the black slider up because as you look at the histogram, it's very heavy on the black side, on the underexposed side, or in the tonal, the black tonal side. So I'm going to pull that up as well. And I'm going to move it off the clipping for right now just to open up the range a bit more. So here's where that leads with all these values. And as I come down here to the present slider, I'm going to boost the clarity, which is a micro contrast. I'm going to boost that up quite a bit. And leave that there. And typically, I check out what the contrast curves will do some medium curve, and I will leave that there because it gives it a bit of a punch. And now at this point, I'm going to go into my selective editing tools. What I chose to do as I was playing around with this the first time, I'm going to use a radial filter, and I want to create my own vignette effect by using the radial filter, and I click and drag, and I want to highlight this area. I want to highlight the rain, the raindrops, or the rivulets, and the Ford logo. So I'm creating a filter or an area, and then I'm going to uncheck invert mask so that any of the effects that I apply will be applied outside the area. So I'm going to decrease the exposure on the outside and create a vignette. Oops, we'll do it here. And just darken the outside. Now, here's where I started to get a little funky. I decided I also wanted to increase the clarity of this area. And so I created another radial filter, and I can do that by right-clicking on the filter, and you'll see I can duplicate it. Now, when I duplicate it, it duplicates at the same setting as the original filter, so that's why the outside areas became dark, twice as dark. I need to move these filters apart, so I slide them apart, so I can click on the buttons and activate the one I want to work on. Here's on this one, I'm going to zero out the values, and I want to boost. Now this time I want the effect inside the area, so I click invert mask, and then I'm going to boost the clarity. And according to my notes, I boosted it quite a ways, up to that point, 67. And I also did, and then I decreased the exposure a bit. Okay, so that's what I did with the radial filters. Now, and then I clicked done. The next thing I did was I wanted to tone down the exposure and highlights of the logo. And for that, I used the adjustment brush. So I've come over and I click on the adjustment brush, and always make sure to zero out the values. And you can do that by double clicking. And the slider that you double click will set back to zero. You can also do that if you double click on effect, it will zero out all the sliders. That's an easier way. So what I want to do here, I want to color in the logo, and I want to, so that I see where I color, I come down and I click on show selected mask overlay. And I begin to color, and the red, of course, shows the mask. And I'm not going to be incredibly careful here. And like I've shown in other videos before, if I get outside of the area, and again, as I'm doing this, I'm holding down on the mouse button, and that allows me to keep coloring. If I go outside, then I click on the Alt button, and it changes it to an eraser. And I just erase that area. When I let go of the Alt button, it turns it back in to the adjustment brush, or the coloring portion of the adjustment brush. Okay, so I've got that colored in. And now I want to apply some effects. And to see how those effects work, I come back down and I uncheck show selected up mask overlay. And now I come back up to the sliders. So here's a slider, and I'm going to decrease the exposure. Just a step there, and you can see this is darkened, of course. And I'm also going to bring down the highlights because the chrome around the logo is a bit bright. So I'm going to bring that down quite a bit. And because I initially had increased the exposure in this area, I want to check on the noise. So I'm going to come over to the Navigator panel and I'm going to zoom in 2:2 and or 2:1, and you can see some noise in here. So I am I'm going to use the noise filter here and just see what that gets me. I'm going to crank that up a bit because I also want to boost clarity just a little bit in here as well. So we'll leave that there, and I'm going to back out, come back to the fit view. If my, oh, what was that? Okay, my Lightroom is thinking. Sometimes that happens. Well, let me click done. And I've got a not responding. And that will happen too. So I'm giving it a rest and giving it time to catch up with what I've done and see what happens. Oh, and I've lost it. Okay, we're back online now. So now that I've done my work with the logo, checking back in my notes, another thing that I did was I used the adjustment brush, another adjustment brush. I'm going to click on it and create a new one to decrease highlights in this area around the grill. Okay, and I did that just, I used a wide brush and I, again, I clicked the overlay. I'm creating a new adjustment brush and I'm going to, click the overlay and I'm going to just color in some of the areas. And I'm having a bit of trouble. There we go. So I'm going to bring it down here. I'm going to bring it across here and to really pull the eye. And I also did some detail work in here as well. And I really spent some time kind of outlining the rivulets. I really wanted them to pop. Okay, so colored that in, and I'm going to uncheck the overlay, and I'm going to load in the exposure, and we'll see what happens if this is performing. Okay, there it goes. So I've darkened that. See, there's, I will bump it up again, and I'm going to slide it back down to where it darkens those areas, and I may come back in and make sure that this area is a little bit darker. Okay, so then I'm going to click done. The next thing down in my detail panel, you'll see that a sharpening preset has been applied. This is called something that I've loaded in on my own, my preset. It's Sharpen Raw Scenic, and these are the values. And as I move in, I'm going to go into the 2:1 view and see how the noise level looks. And I'd like to just deal with a bit of the noise. And for that, I'm going to slide the luminance slider just a bit. And then to recapture some, just a bit of the detail that the luminance has taken out, I'll just bump that up a bit. And then I'm going to come back to the full view, hopefully. There we go. Now, one of the last things I want to do, I think I want to rotate this image. It's a little bit flat looking here, so I'm going to go back up to my crop tool and I'm going to play with the rotation, the angle, and I'm going to take it this way so that I can keep in the lights on the bumper, and I'm going to leave it about there and let's see how that looks. I'll click done. And I like that because it's got the lights and it, I like the angle. And last, as I always do, I come down to effects. I'm going to apply a post-crop vignette, which I have preset a number of them over here in my panel. And I'm going to try vignette number two. And there we go. That darkened it up. And you can see I like the logo is bright. The tail end of the rivulet is highlighted. And I think that's where I'm going to leave it. Crazy as my process was, again, this could have perhaps been accomplished more simply, but that was the flow that I followed. So you saw some interesting things today. I hope you've enjoyed this week's video. Apologies for the glitches in my Lightroom program. Please feel free to ask any questions in the comments section and to see more post-processing videos and galleries of after-before photos, visit visualventuring.com and select After Before Friday Forum in the menu. Thanks so much for watching.